Definition or the basic translation of the word masjid means the place where you go into prostration position, so where you prostrate. When you go into the prostration position, that's a sajda, we call it, or a masjid. So a mosque basically means the place where you go into prostration. And other than that, other than meaning where you go into prostration, it's a house of God. It's a holy place. It's a sanctuary for people. It's a place where they come to connect to God. The niche is a very important part of a mosque. Because a niche is the place where the imam would stand. It's the place where it is pointing or directed towards Mecca. And that's actually where all of the mosques around the world would be directed to. They are directed towards Mecca. We pray facing the direction of Mecca. So the niche is the place where the imam would stand to lead the prayer. And the niche would basically be like a carving in the wall. Or sometimes it's just a small window. A dome gives a mosque height. It gives it, a bigger feeling. It gives it a more peaceful feeling as well when you have a dome inside the mosque. Another important aspect of the mosque, because that's where the muezzin used to climb up to call for the prayer. A muezzin would climb up the minaret and call for the prayer from the top of the minarets. Nowadays it's done inside the mosque through microphones, but the minarets is actually the place where an imam would call for the prayer, or a muezzin would call for the prayer. And the word for minarets in Arabic is ma'dana. And a ma'dana is basically where you call for the adhan, for the call for the prayer. The adhan is basically the call for the prayer. So when you hear people saying it's time for the adhan, or the adhan is taking place, they're basically referring to the call for the prayer. And the call for the prayer is the call that tells people that it's time to pray. And that's approximately 20 minutes, at least here in the UAE, it's approximately 20 minutes before the time for the prayer. So the imam, or the leader of the prayer, would come into the mosque and he would call for the prayer, telling people that it's time to come and pray. And basically what would be said during that is that they would say that God is the greatest. That's how it starts. It says Allahu Akbar at the beginning, and it says God is the greatest. And then we declare the oneness of God, that there is only one God and no other God equal to him, and that Prophet Muhammad is his last messenger. And then it goes on to tell people that it's time for the prayer. Come to prayer, come to prayer, come to success, come to success.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu. La ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي
The person who calls for the prayer, and he could be the imam of the prayer, the imam of the mosque. And the imam of the mosque is the leader. The word imam means a leader, so he's the person who leads the prayer. So even here, like in every mosque, the muezzin, the person who calls for the prayer, is the imam at the same time. And how is he chosen? He's chosen by the Department of Islamic Affairs, at least here in the UAE. He would apply for his job just like applying to any other job. He would take his CV and he would go to the Department of Islamic Affairs and tell them that he wants to be an imam of a specific mosque. Then the criteria that they choose him based on is if he has a wide knowledge of the religion, if he has been through specific studies of the religion, a university or a college or school, and then after that based on his voice. Because when they choose a muezzin or an imam for the prayer, he has to be someone with a nice voice.
First of all, a person entering the mosque, they should know what they're doing. They should know why they're going to the mosque. When a Muslim, he comes to the mosque, they make sure they're in the state of wudu. It means they have washed and prepared for the prayer. When they enter the mosque, they know that they must remove their shoes and slippers before entering the mosque. When you enter inside, you know that you remain quiet. You come inside, you pray your prayers, respect for entering the mosque. It is a preparation, you know? Not only physically, you're washing your hands, no. You are spiritually, you're cleaning yourself. And one of the most important parts of the wudu is you are preparing yourself mentally. Mentally, you're preparing yourself for prayer. Dress code, this goes for both the men and the women. The men, they must cover their bodies from above their navel to below their knees. The women must cover their entire body except for their face and their hands. Now, this is in the Holy Quran. God tells the people to dress modest, meaning to dress decent. So therefore, you wear clothes which do not reveal your beauty or the shape of your body. So when they come to the mosque, they want to wear loose clothing, you know, clothing which doesn't attract too much attention, you know, which doesn't distract other people. must make their way to the mosque. Whenever, if they can hear the call to prayer, they should make their way to the mosque, if they're able to hear. If they're not able to hear, they should pray where they are able to, where they're at, like if they're at home, they pray at home. Or if they're at work, they pray at work. But they should know the prayer timings, at least, and then they should do the prayer at that time.
By having these prayers 5 times a day, we are making sure that we are following the right path. We are not doing wrong things.
To pray the 5 prayers a day, we're remembering God the entire day. You know, when we pray to God, we're remembering God. So therefore, like the Muslims say, your prayer is like your rope to God. So when you pray, you are strengthening that rope. You are thickening that connection between you and God.